Alright, so navigation. I need to set a direct flight plan to K. I'm gonna turn this knob. I can't type in the entry. So K, oops, past K. K, next character. Oh, previous character. Next character, K. L. Yeah. Wish it didn't do a stupid little tooltip to block me. L. I don't want to navigate. I want to turn this to JK. L. You T-K-F-G-H. Cincinnati Municipal Airport, Lunken. Enter. Activate enter. Okay, so now we got entered into our navigation computer. I'm going to go to Lunken International Airport. We're at Columbus Airport. Which airport are we at? We're at John Glenn Columbus International right now. We're going to be doing a short hop down to Cincinnati, Cincinnati Municipal Airport, also known as Lunken Field. We're in a Cessna Grand Caravan, turboprop aircraft. We are sitting on the runway waiting to take off. The weather is rainy. It is 6:34 in the morning, real time, real weather. So let's set up our I want to select an altitude to start off with, let's say, a little bit too much. Start off at 3,000 feet, do a vertical climb rate of, well, let's say 1,000 feet a minute. That should be good. We want to navigate and flight direction. Now, autopilot is not on right now. We'll turn the autopilot on after takeoff. And now we are ready for takeoff, so let's go ahead and let it line this up because that's where they're supposed to be. And parking brake. I don't have rudder controls, so I have to use the keyboard, which is not ideal. You'll see why in a minute. Dogs are playing. Alright, so. Control, period. Turns off the parking brake. And let's throw up. Play once a period for the left or something. And we are airborne. Now, since this aircraft does not have a retractable landing gear. We don't have to worry about that. Autopilot's fine. Okay, we're down cruising at 2240, 50. It's about on our way up to 2000 feet. And we're now flying over Columbus. Go ahead and get your flaps. Flaps cause give us more lift, but they also cause crash. Okay, I should have turned the no smoking and no seatbelt sign. Turn the cabin lights on to get the patch people a little more comfortable. Just pretend to be one here. Pumpy was pretty windy. It's a beautiful morning. Yeah, we're cruising at 154.5 knots. We're at 3,000 feet. Let's go ahead and increase our altitude to 5,000 feet. I have my co-pilot here. Line shows that we're following the navigation. You see the navigation map is also on this display. We could turn that off because we also have it on this display. This shows our engine torque, ITT, which says the temperature to 155, our RPMs, oil pressures, our fuel levels, and then this just shows the navigation path and all of that. You can see that we're climbing up to 5,000 feet here. Our destination here is KLEK, Lunken. Right here is our electric panel. Now, since I started the simulation on the runway, I didn't have to start a flight or anything. These are for everything, so I'll do a few simulation. Light stuff. There's no icing right now, so we don't have to do the car in the base of instrument controls, just in case you lose your fancy little computer that probably cost a fortune. Versus aircraft, Cessna Caravan, probably cost a small fortune. Look at a beautiful sunset up there. Anyways, you got 77 nautical miles to go. Here's the highway. That's most likely about Route 71 down here. You know what? That kind of looks like Rogue City. I wouldn't be surprised if it is. Yep, it is. Recognized by the off. And then the way the highway turns this way, that go through that many times. Anyways, my AI co-pilot is command radio comms. I can also have him fly a plane and assist the checklist. We're not worried about checklists right now. Okay, we're not flying that. We'll stay up here. This is a short flight, it doesn't really make sense. We're going to fly out. Sunrise. See how high the yoke when I play with these controls? Put it back here. Put it back there. Here's the compass radios and stuff. Control radio message panel, obviously. Outside view. We have rain clouds. Just waiting when I got up this morning, so. My pets are begging for my attention. Guys? Is that what? Yeah. Getting flying an airplane right now. Getting a 40 flight back to Cincinnati.
They're landing at the airport. It's like Nick said, dog park. Yeah. Boys.
Hey, so 68 nautical miles left. And we're flying above a bunch of farm fields. I find the drive between Cincinnati and Columbus rather boring. You want to drive on the highway? Going through a bunch of farm fields and stuff.
132.3 says next rate Gulf Sierra. Columbus approach says to Alpha Sierra next rate Gulf Sierra 5,000 feet.
I could theoretically fly slower and save fuel, but do a nice speed of 164 knots here. Fuels, the selectors are up there, just up there, down here, but those are not full. Not the controls are not full yet. A lot of them are. I mean, these things are all completely realistic. I wonder how much Microsoft had to pay the license. Farming. And also this is like very realistic operation. So not only does the flight simulator simulate the flights, but also simulates the navigation systems. Just hop around and this airplane doesn't have any batteries on board, sorry. Please don't make a mess. You probably should not have had that breakfast burrito at the McDonald's. Hey, no smoking back there. You cannot even e-cigarettes. No, you cannot smoke. That's Wilmington, two runways. So that's the KILA, which is also the abbreviation for the radar for the weather station. Yeah, so that should filter our navigation world map. Here's our flight path. That's really the weather station. It has a pretty decent sized airport too. Look at that. Two really long runways. We PA gun for girls. We get to like 15-10 miles per hour. There's a lot of little airstrips. A lot of, if you look at the navigation map, you'll see a bunch of, there's another airplane up there. Watching for ice. I think it's broken for ice. They were going to tie up. Back outside. So, the computer is an old Dell XPS system that I got several years ago. It was a, like a 6th or 7th gen i7 processor, so 4-core processor. I have 32 gigabytes of memory, but the graphics card is a UTI, Radeon, something or another, GX, something like that. It's a very decent graphics card. Not like a really high-end one, probably more medium-end. But it has 8 gigabytes of graphics memory, dedicated graphics memory, so, yeah, it's almost done with it for sure. See the airports. So yeah, this, as you see, this computer does handle bike simulator fairly well. I do need some chopping to set it down. I have a co-worker that his dad is going into aviation. He says I would like to get my dad in the simulation because he has a couple of these computer playing. I mean, it really does take advantage of modern graphics hardware. Raw photos and stuff like that in the realistic world. Realistic weather. The flight simulator uses, you know, Bing Maps, which is a lot of people replacing objects with Google Maps too. Just putting it into the simulation. It's a fascinating technology. It builds 3D models for buildings based off the shape of the satellite images. Some of the models are also handcrafted models, which are much better than laser. And so Wilmington is practically the halfway point, I think. Practically 47 nautical miles out of Cincinnati, Georgia. We're in the Rock Hill, but still in the reeds. Like I said, we sit there and come up with a lot of water. Get on the like 7 foot right there. Muffin, what you knock on the floor? Oh, you knocked the freight car down.
In the box.
Lovely. Yeah, I have a lot of cat-related knocking over what's going on.
Let's get on the counter.
Like this doesn't go in here. Off. And so weather. Into a really dense rainfall. Oddly enough, I don't see much rain when it comes to the chicken stuff. So. Probably. Yeah, see, that was really terrible. Yeah, there's a cop. This must be a cloud that made people have to rain. Miles out. Thing is, this computer has the game is installed on a hard drive, so it takes forever to replace that hard drive with an SSD.
shuffle around.
I'm going to see if you can find Lunken. Nautical miles out. Let's descend down to
Cincinnati approach Cessna Alpha Sierra and X-ray Gulf Sierra 5,000 feet.
Cessna Alpha Sierra X-ray Gulf Sierra Cincinnati approach continuous plan. Altimeter 29.94.
Alpha Sierra, X-Ray Golf Sierra, is 1.1 miles northeast with Oscar to land.
Cincinnati Alpha Sierra, X-Ray Golf Sierra, Lunken Tower. Flight straight, runway 25. Altimeter 290, decimal 905, wind 261 to 23.
Bend straight and runway 25, Cincinnati X-Ray Golf Sierra.
Now 25 is the direction on the compass, 250 degrees, which is basically directly in front of us. We're heading 250 degrees right here. Watch my speed. On runway 25, which is one dead ahead of us. Okay, when landing, you use the throttle to control altitude. You gotta be careful because this is a turboprop, which means the jet engine is actually running the prop. There is a delay in thrust, so. I haven't exactly mastered this yet, so I am not an expert like an airplane. That will help write more planes. The problem is I need more bread. Thank you. that would be good. Another airplane on the runway.
Crap.
That was not. It's gonna be a rough flight, man. Like I said, I have not mastered this at all. Oops. Roll down the ground. Oh, let's keep it out of those. Well, I did land. The problem is that I'm using the keyboard for rudder control.
Lunken 1-Decimal, land for Cessna X-ray, Galsy Air.
And my keyboard fell off my table here when I went to. So that's why I kind of went off the runway there. But the good news is I didn't crash. So let's not exactly the best landing ever, but I am pretty happy. I forgot to turn my landing lights on. Lovely. So, we made it to Cincinnati, Lunken. Not the best landing. And of course, it was very windy. And then, of course, my keyboard fell when I was trying to operate. So when I get the rudder controls, which I have not because I ordered this flight yoke and control stick. It was back ordered because the thing that happens when flight simulator came out, all this sold out immediately, and people that did have it wanted like $400 to $500 for it. I wasn't going to spend that much. So I back ordered it when Logitech said they had it in stock. I got it off Amazon. So I paid the normal price, and I was supposed to wait until December. Well, it arrived 2 days later. I was a bit surprised. Well, I said, okay, then I'll go order the flight yoke. And, well, guess what? The rudder controls. Well, guess what? The rudder controls are no longer available. They're like $500. But I really would like to get them make better. And I need to do more practice flights between Cincinnati and Columbus because it's a short flight. And practice my landing